We're talking with James Stenson, noted photographer and director of the documentary Kelly. Welcome, James. Welcome to Kansas City.
Thank you.
How did you first meet Kelly, and how did that sort of lead to you deciding to do a film about her?
We first met Kelly about 2 years ago. I did an open call, cast calling for an interactive internet piece that I was doing on portraits on prostitutes in LA. And Kelly came into the room, and this amazing kid just opened up and started talking to us. We never stopped filming. It went from a 20-minute sitting to 100 days of filming. It was very much an accident, because I don't come from a film background, I come from a stills background. I mean, the story is, it's a provincial girl who comes to Hollywood for the dream, and the machine eats her up. I think that's what happened when we first met Kelly. She came into it. She thought this may be her time. This may be her moment to be on film. And that began the process. Certainly began the process. And it's the reason why she sort of responded to the post on Craigslist that I put out for her capacity. So I think what happened then, she literally started playing, there were points, there's moments when I'm kind of like, it's not real, it's Kelly being Kelly.
So it's more of like a performance.
But what happens is when you spend that amount of time, that much time with somebody, you get the real person. Because they get bored with the performance, and they begin to relax. And Kelly's had a lot of men in and out of her life. Some paid, some not, but me and one of my colleagues spent a lot of time just sitting down talking to her, and that was it. It was just an awful lot of time drinking tea and trying to feed this kid hamburgers. She never ate because of the drug use. And there is that point where you kind of cross the line. With Kelly, I mean, when we first met Kelly, she was earning $160,000 a year as a prostitute. She, within a very short period of time, went from earning a huge amount of money to being penniless. And one of the things that I didn't cross the line. There were moments when I was like, okay, we need to leave. There's moments when we did leave, particularly when her boyfriend slash pimp was around in the scene. But there was one occasion where I was like, okay, let's go and pick her up. And there was a phone call at 2 o'clock in the morning, and she was just being kicked out of the hotel, so we just booked our book trip to another hotel. But that was the thing, she had such a crazy life that she would vanish for weeks on end, if not months at times. The eviction. The big confusion about the eviction is she didn't really understand what the word eviction meant. So the day when the babies knocked on the doors, she was like, what are you doing? Well, like, we're evicting you. And she's like, what do you mean you're evicting me? Doesn't that mean I just paid the rent? They're like, no, you're out.
What sort of reaction have you had, I guess, to the film?
It's been positive and negative, particularly from the LGBT community, because it's a true film. I mean, that's what the film is. It's a portrait. It's a portrait of a girl in a very short period of time, about 12 months. And it's full of cliches. Cliches are cliches for reasons. Kelly is the person that she is. There's no fiction to the film. And it's not necessarily a positive light on the transgender community, because she felt like there was no escape. She fell into a life of prostitution and carried in on prostitution. And that was one of the things about Kelly's, is she now realizes it because she's being sober. But she needed to escape from the life that she created for herself, which was, she'd been a prostitute from the age of 15. and that's all she saw that she could do. I think with just with the nature of documentary, you can't spend that much time with people and just stop talking to them just like that. I think it's important to still have discourse with people, but still distance yourself. We do speak usually once a month. We definitely over text. One of the other producers speaks with Kelly regularly because she's back in North Carolina with her mother. And she's clean and sober at the moment, so hopefully she'll see that. Mum's not seen the film. I couldn't believe she gave me a release form. No, Kelly saw the film in a kind of controlled environment. I gave her a screening. She had a screening, and she had an hour break, and then she had another screening. And it was just an environment where I felt secure the fact that she would watch the film, see. I was concerned that she may fall off the wagon, something may happen, but she saw it and she learned something from the film. She saw the darkness that was taking over, she saw the journey that she'd gone through, and she also was surprised at some of the footage. She's like, when did you film that? And there was blocks of the film that she didn't even remember filming, because she was just completely crying. Absolutely high, which is sad. I mean, that's the thing. And then, as I say, we did an awful lot of interviews with Kelly and spent a lot of time with her. And for those moments, just the idea of that she was like, okay, and she actually said, that was a dark period in my life. I'm glad I'm through that now. It was a great thing. I was like, great. It kind of makes me feel like it's a good thing.